AC alternators, three phase AC alternators. Welcome back again in the new video of Power Learning channel. So my dear friends, in today's video we will discuss about AC three phase alternator, which are used in diesel generators. AC alternator is a main component of diesel generator. Diesel generator having two main components, one is diesel engine and the other is AC alternator. So in today's video we'll discuss about three phase AC alternator. So once the three phase AC alternator is coupled with the engine, it will produce AC electrical power, which is three phase. In industrial generator we are producing three phase electrical power. Three phase power is very common requirement of all the electrical item which used in industries. So in today's video I will explain you in details how the AC alternator is producing electricity while it's taking mechanical power from the diesel engine. The diesel engine is coupled with the alternator and diesel engine is only producing the mechanical power, and it's giving this mechanical power on its engine shaft, which is having flywheel, and the flywheel is coupled with the coupling plate of the alternator. So the main rotor of the alternator is coupled and it is rotating with the power of engine. So the alternator having several parts, so I will explain you about these parts. So the number one is main stator and then main rotor. After that we have exciter stator and we have exciter rotor. So these are the four main parts, four main windings which we have on our alternator: main rotor, main stator, exciter rotor and exciter stator. So as you see on the screen now, these are the complete alternators without engine. Okay, so on this we have this coupling plate, okay, and we have also terminal box. From the terminal box we took the power and we will connect to our panels where we need the electrical power. Alternators are available in single bearing and double bearing specification. Now you see on the screen, this is a complete genset which is coupled with the alternator. As you see on the screen now, the rear part is alternator and the front part is the engine. And here also we have in our generator the control panel from where the operator can operate the generator. So now you will see what is exciter stator. So this is the exciter stator. Okay, I will explain you about it, and this is the main rotor and exciter rotor. So my dear friends, welcome again. So now with the help of this picture and this picture, we will understand that how our self-excited alternator is producing electricity with the help of diesel engine. The diesel engine is coupled with the main rotor. The shaft, as you see in the picture, this shaft having a disc plate which is connected on the flywheel of the engine, and once the engine is rotating, the flywheel is which is connected with the connecting plate of the stator, our alternator is revolving also the main rotor of our alternator. So what is the link between the revolving of main rotor, why we are making rotation of the main rotor, and how the electricity is produced? So first of all, you will aware about the parts of the main stator, main alternator. So here if you see, we have shaft which is coupled with our engine, then we have bearing, and we have fan is using for alternator cooling. And here if you see, we have two wires and one is dotted wire. This is AVR, source of power and sensing from alternator output. Okay, sometimes we are using two phase and sometimes we are using three phase, And these wires, as you see, is going to our AVR. AVR is sensing the main stator voltage and giving DC power to the exciter stator. This part which you see, this is exciter stator, and the in between, this is called exciter rotor. So now I will take you on this picture. As you see in the 3D view, the main component of the alternator are stator, and inside the stator we place the stator winding, which is red color. These three wires, as you see, these are the main stator winding which is connected to our load and supplying the AC power. Okay, and this AC power we took from here, sensing voltage for our AVR. So now what will happen, once the voltage is generated, it will give sensing voltage to the AVR, and once the AVR is getting sensing voltage from the main stator, this reference voltage will generate the AVR DC voltage, and this DC voltage will excite our exciter stator windings. Once the flux is produced inside the field winding of the exciter stator, the revolving armature of the exciter stator will cut the magnetic line of force, and it will produce the three-phase AC power. This three-phase AC power will connect with on our diode plate, and this diode plate is having three-phase diode assembly, which will convert this diode AC power, three-phase AC power, to the DC, and this DC power will go to our main rotor. So in this way, our main rotor will get excited, and our main rotor having four poles. We have two north pole and two south pole, and these two wire, positive and negative, will excite and make it as an electromagnet. Once this electromagnet rotor is revolved inside the stator winding, so it will again produce the electrical power, the voltage. So this is the simple way to understand that how the electricity is produced, and this system is called self-excitation system of our alternator. This kind of alternator is called self-excitation alternator. So now you see, you understand how the voltage is produced in the self-excitation system. In the self-excitation system, the main rotor, which is coupled with alternator, is revolving inside the main stator winding, and once the magnetic flux is produced on the main rotor and within the air gap, the stator winding will cut the magnetic flux, the magnetic field, it will produce the electrical power. Here, if you want to see, as you see, the main rotor is in the middle and the main stator winding is on the in the parallel of the main rotor. Once the revolving shaft is moved with the help of the diesel engine, it will produce electrical power. So my dear friends, if you have any question, you can ask me in the comment below. Inshallah, in next video, I will try to explain about permanent magnet generator excitation system. So thanks for watching Power Learning Channel. See you in the next video. Till that, take care and have a nice day. Assalamu alaikum.